One issue that comes up often when living at home and being confined to our homes is the question of davening near little kids. And there are many issues that come up. However, one in particular that I'd like to focus on is the question of davening in a place where there is a bad odor. The pasuk in Parashas Ki Tetzeh tells us that your camps literally should be holy, which Chazal interpret as meaning that when I'm involved in a davar shebekdusha, when I'm making a bracha, when I'm davening, when I'm reciting Kriya Shema, any of the above, then one may not do so in an area which has a bad odor, such as a bathroom. Moshe Feinstein points out that even though our bathrooms are much cleaner and more sanitary than they used to be, the prohibition absolutely would still apply, and therefore it is strictly prohibited to recite any bracha or tefillah while in the bathroom itself. However, that's not only in the context and not only in the area of a bathroom, but anywhere else where there may be a poor odor, the same thing would apply. So near a smelly garbage, one could not daven. And likewise, if there are any other malodorous items which may be found in one's home, so one cannot daven there. Now, how far does that go? So Shulchan Aruch writes that as long as one can either see it uncovered or smell it. So if you can see it, but it doesn't smell, or you smell it even if you do not see it, so one may not daven or learn there. However, if one is a minimum of 4 amos, which is 6 or so feet in front of that item, and there is no clear smell from it, then it would be permissible to daven there. So if it's in front of me and I can see it, even if I don't smell it, that's prohibited. And if it's behind me, if it's more than 6 or so feet behind me and it does not smell, then it would be permissible. However, if the odor is covered up, then as long as one does not smell it, then they may daven and even make brachos near that. So this becomes very relevant, certainly when there are little children around. Let's say there's a child in the area where I'm davening, and that child happens to have a soiled diaper. So then there's a question, can I daven in that area? Can I make brachos right next to or even holding that child? So obviously, if one smells the diaper, then one cannot daven there. But what happens if, let's say, somehow I know that that diaper is dirty, but it is still closed up, and there is no strong odor being emitted from the diaper. So Rav Schechter quotes from Rav Moshe that is considered to be covered. And then one can daven and make brachos even right there, even if I know that it's a soiled diaper. But if I don't see it, that's considered covered up while the diaper is still closed. And I cannot smell it. So that would be permitted. However, there are some posting that still would be strict and say that you have to be 4 hours from the soiled diaper, even if I don't smell it. And even if it's closed, the very fact that I know that that diaper is a soiled diaper, then I need to be at least 4 amos or 6 feet in front of that. It is important to note that even those that are otherwise strict, right, that say that even if there is no smell and it's covered up, I need to be 6 feet in front of it, that's only if I know that the diaper is dirty. However, there is not a requirement to go out of my way. If I don't smell anything and I have no way of knowing, there's not a requirement to go out of my way and to check. I could daven and make brachos accordingly. If it comes to my attention very clearly that it is dirty, so then it would depend on the factors above. Do I smell it? And if not, then it would be subject of the machlokas between Rav Schechter of Moshe and Rav Simcha Banim Kohen and other poskim that would be strict even in that regard. Have a great day.